The Nsfas continuing students who started in 2018 or thereafter, they actually have no debt. The issue, the students who normally have debt, one is Nsfas students who were funded prior to 2018. In the past, we have contributed in relieving those students by government absorbing some of that debt. But in addition, we had negotiated with the institutions that in the case of those students, with acknowledgement of debt, they must be allowed to continue and finish. Some universities have entered into an arrangement with some of such students. And we are saying as government, we are also going to be engaging institutions in particular to prioritize those who are doing well and are doing their final years, such that they are able to sign acknowledgement of debt, be allowed to register so that they can complete and will be able to pay once they actually start working. Nsfas will be able to release funding and the registration process at public university can indeed now continue as planned. Non-Nsfas qualifying students have been affected by these delays as universities have agreed to extend the registration period to ensure that students without funding decisions would not be prevented from accessing a place that they qualified for. We agreed with the vice chancellors on Monday that the registration period is extended for first-time entering students until the end of next week. By pleading with the SABC television, they are running a wrong role on their screen. They are saying, Minister Nzimande says there will be no funding for first time entering students. That's not true. That's not what I have said. In fact, what we are announcing today is that Nsfas qualifying students who have been admitted to institutions are going to be funded. We started addressing the problem as early as towards the end of last year. The reason why it has taken us to this extent, you must bear in mind that the academic year has actually finished late. And it was only right towards the end of the academic year that we could get the full scale of the nature and the amount of the shortfall. So to give an impression that we've allowed this problem to be at this stage, we've been doing nothing, is completely incorrect. On the question which was asking the amount of money to fund students in 2021, they have now moved from just under 36 billion rands last year, and they're going to be 42.1 billion rands this year.